Virginia University's Creative Arts Center, Lyle B. Clay Concert Theater. For your safety, we would like to point out illuminated exits to your left and right. In the event of an emergency, you will be directed to the appropriate exit. At this time, we ask that you turn off all cell phones, pagers, and audible alarms as a courtesy to all. We would also like to remind you that the use of photographic and recording equipment is prohibited by law. Thank you for your attention.
Gustav Holst, who influenced Frank Ticheli's earlier musical development. So naturally, I think Holst would have had a really huge impact on Frank Ticheli, be it consciously or even subconsciously. Before we perform our next piece, I would like to invite the composer to the stage to share a few words about what inspired this piece and what it means to him. We have had the fortune of having Kevin Day, our resident composer, with us for a brief but very impactful residency, and the students have all had the opportunity to grow and learn from him. Please join me in welcoming the composer of A Song for Tomorrow to the stage, Mr. Kevin Day.
It's an honor to get to be here. I have had the pleasure the last few months to visit various schools across the U.S. I've been traveling for a while, and I've been working with a lot of wind bands and orchestras and chamber groups, and so this is my last residency tonight. And what makes this really interesting is I was actually born in West Virginia in 1996. And so one of my parents is from Logan and the other one is from Charleston. And so they had me and they moved to Texas when I was very little. And so this kind of feels like a homecoming in a sense. I haven't came back to West Virginia in a very long time. And so to get to have my last residency here for the school year has been really a wonderful time. And so it's an honor to get to be here tonight. You're going to hear three pieces of mine tonight. The first one is entitled A Song for Tomorrow, which was written in memory of a friend of mine who I knew in high school who passed away. And what this piece is about, hinting the title, is more in reference of this was composed as a song of comfort to those who knew this person, and to those of us who know loss, to be able to take it one day at a time, to be able to have hope for tomorrow. And so I hope you enjoy my first composition tonight with this wonderful wind band here. This is A Song for Tomorrow.
originally in class, we sight read it, and I told him that it was absolutely just bottled joy. So we hope you were able to, as a listener, get that feeling that Frank Turner was trying to put across, which is really fantastic. Now, as our portion of the concert comes to a close, I want to thank the College of Creative Arts Operation Team. And they've done an incredible job. I want to make sure that we recognize Mike and Pete, Professors Zay, Professor Swiger, and also Professor Benicosa for all the work that they do behind the scenes. We also want to make sure that we recognize our College of Creative Arts Administration, Dr. Keith Jackson, whom we'll hear from a little bit later on this evening as a soloist with the Wind Symphony, and you really don't want to miss that. It's a really fantastic piece. Professor John Hendricks and Dr. Michael Ibrahim, the director of the school, thank you guys so much for all you do for WVU Bands. I would also like to thank our faculty, our staff, my colleagues, Scott Tobias, but most importantly, I am interested in thanking these young people behind me on the stage. Thank you so much for showing up. Thank you so much for working hard and doing everything that you could to pour into yourself and also to pour into this art form. I am really, really bowled over, and I'm grateful so much for the work that you do. So please join me in giving them a round of applause.
Thank you. Thank you.
based on my experience playing jazz piano and in various groups, combos, clubs. So it's a lot of this music that I've been playing the last few years, and so it was really a thrill to hear that. You won't hear the next piece of mine until the end of the concert, but that piece is called A Dancing Fire, and it is actually one of the first few pieces I wrote for wind band when I was an undergrad. And so, kind of in a similar vein as mine, but it's more of like a show-offy kind of fanfare piece for the band. And so they'll play that as their last selection of the program. So I hope you enjoy the rest of tonight's concert. It's been a thrill to be here with all of you, and hope you enjoy.
The next two selections that we're going to do come from the pen of George Gershwin, great American composer from the early part of the 20th century. The first of the two pieces we'll do is a transcription of the second prelude from Gershwin's three preludes, Jackson, Dean of the College of Creative Arts, and I spoke about this about 2 or 3 years ago. The schedules of soloists never really worked out, and then the pandemic happened. But now we're very excited. We're back to live music with live audiences, and schedules worked out with our soloists. So we're thrilled to finally bring this to fruition after about 2 or 3 years. The piece is entitled Rosa Parks Boulevard. It's by Michael Daugherty, who currently teaches composition at the University of Michigan. It is an homage, celebration, tribute to Rosa Parks, civil rights heroine. And it is written for 3 solo trombones plus wind ensemble. And we have 3 very special soloists joining us this evening. First joining us is WVU alum, Dr. Joseph Jefferson, who is currently the professor of trombone at Southeast Missouri State University, and is also the 2022 recipient of the National Jazz Educator of the Year Award from the Jazz Educators Network. He'll be joined on stage by Hakeem Bilal, who is currently professor of trombone here at West Virginia University, and of course, Keith Jackson, who is currently dean of the College of Creative Arts. It's a privilege to be able to share the stage with these outstanding musicians, and we look forward to this performance we've been waiting for 3 years to do. So would you please join me in welcoming these outstanding gentlemen to the stage as we perform Rosa Parks Boulevard by Michael Daugherty. due to the fact they're graduating in a couple of weeks, or they hope to be. And we have a couple that are going on to internships involved with various programs such as music dentistry and or music education with their student teaching. So I'm going to call their names now. If you would not mind, just hold your applause and we'll recognize all of them at one time at the very end. When we have leaving us, and we will miss them greatly, J.C. Creighton, who's getting a bachelor's degree in music performance. We have Julia Stocking, who is getting a bachelor of arts degree in music. Alicia Rafter is completing her master's degree in music performance. Mark Wallace is finishing his master's degree in conducting. Nate Gnesky is finishing his music performance degree at the percussion section. Aaron Freeman will be student teaching in the fall before moving on to his music ed degree, finishing in December. And Kel Campbell will be moving on to his music industry studies work in the fall. Would you please join me in congratulating these students? Fire, and I think it's a very appropriate title, and I think you'll